Network, the solution for humanity.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه, أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we will begin the actual study of the hadiths of Kitab al-Buyu' from Umdat al-Ahkam. And the first hadith and the second hadith that we will take now. The first one was narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him and with his father. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the buyer and the seller have the choice to cancel or to confirm the bargain before they separate from each other while being together. This is first part. The Arabic, al-bayyani bil-khiyar, ma lam yatafarraqa. The two people buying and selling, they have the option either to go ahead or to cancel as long as they are being together. They do not separate. The second part of the hadith, or one of them gives the other the option to choose. Therefore, if one gives the choice to the other and the deal was done, the deal is final. The second hadith is related, so we will take it as well. Narrated by Hakim ibn Hizam, may Allah be pleased with him. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, both the buyer and the seller have the option of canceling or confirming the bargain unless they separate. If they speak the truth and mention the defects, then their bargain will be blessed. And if they tell lies and conceal the defects, their transaction would lose the blessing, the barakah, from or of Allah. And this was reported in Al-Bukhari. Let's go now and to explain the two hadiths. Hadith Ibn Umar, Hadith Hakim Ibn Hizam. The Prophet is saying, alayhi salatu wasalam, that the buyer and the seller have the choice. What kind of choice? This is known in fiqh as al-khiyar, the choice. And this is from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, meaning it is part of the religion. But the Prophet gives us some conditions. The most important condition is that we do not separate. What is meant by separation? What is known to most of us as acceptable separation? So if you are in a house and you make the transaction and you go to the upper floor or you leave the house, then the deal is final. And I will explain to you again how this is going to take place. Islam gives the choice to the Muslims if they make the wrong decision. Now, sometimes I'm with you in a room and I see your watch and it's, wow, beautiful watch. I want to buy it. And it so happens that the other person doesn't want the watch. Says, okay, how much you're buying it for? He'll say, I'll take it for 1,000. And the man says, I accept. Takes off the watch, puts it on the table. The man takes his wallet, puts the 1,000 on the table. The man takes the money, the man takes the watch. Wow, beautiful watch. The guy says, beautiful money. But while still in the room, after an hour, after 2 hours, they have lunch, they talk, they speak, they have desserts. They do whatever they want. After a while, they did not separate physically. After a while, One of them changes his mind. I said, listen, I think 1,000 is little. I want my watch back. Or the other one says, Akhi, take your watch. 1,000 is a lot of money. I don't want your watch anymore. Is this permissible? The answer is yes. Is it mandatory upon both? Because I sold you the watch, I'm not willing to take it. Khalas, I have the money, I don't want to. No, the Prophet tells us that this is mandatory. Both of us have to accept. If one does not want to continue with the transaction, it is a must. The condition is that we are in the same room. Okay, what about if I take the money of the watch, I gave the watch to my friend, and I said, 1 minute, please. And I leave the room, and I come after 5 minutes. And when he changes his mind, he says, okay, khalas, I changed my mind. Give me my money. I said, it's done. The deal is final. He said, I changed my mind. He said, yo, the Prophet said, as long as they do not separate, I separated. What is the ruling on that? The ruling is haram. This is not permissible, and it's not accounted for. One would say, type, it was reported that Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, used to do this. And he's the narrator of the hadith. He used to separate. He buys something. He used to say 1 minute, and he goes, and he comes back. So the deal is final. Well, scholars said that Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, did not know that there is another hadith where the Prophet says, alayhi salatu wasalam, that you should not leave the room so that you enforce the sale. If you intended to do this, no, this is haram. But if you separate naturally, if he says, listen, I'm going to buy a cheeseburger and come, he goes to buy a cheeseburger and comes, he says, I changed my mind. Khalas, it's final. He cannot change his mind because we separated without the intention of breaking the deal or making the deal. So this is the main condition. The Prophet also says, alayhi salatu wasalam, or you give the choice. What kind of choice? You and I are buying and selling. I have my merchandise, you have your money. Before we make the bargain, I say to you, listen, you do not have the choice. Once we say the deal is done, it's done. Do you agree? He says, I agree. Khalas, I agree, you agree, the deal is done. After 5 minutes, he says, I changed my mind. Can he? The answer is no, because there is mutual agreement that the choice is gone. So this is what is meant by al-khiyar, or the choice of, they call it al-majlis, where we are gathering together. This is in Arabic called khiyar al-majlis. And the choice has a number of different kinds, not only of the majlis. So let us first see if we understand the concept or not. Do we all understand the concept? I go to a place that sells jewelry. I buy a necklace for my wife. I give him the money. He puts it up in a box and he gives it to me. Now, I'm talking about what? Islamic transactions. I'm not talking about what is applicable now. Now, the minute the buyer catches the money, you see a very yellow smile. Khalas, ya akhi, no akhi, don't give me this stuff. I'm not your akhu, I'm not your brother, and you're not my brother. This is money. I'm talking about the Islamic transactions. Why? Because Islam purifies the hearts. So I would not fool you on buying something and then say, khalas, the deal is done. No, you have enough time while we're in the same shop, while we're in the same gathering, to make a choice of your own. Now, the Prophet والسلام, goes on in Hadith Hakim ibn Hizam, and he clarifies to us the same concept, that the buyer and seller have the choice. But scholars say that there are a number of different choices. One of them is the choice of the location, which means that as long as we do not separate physically, the sale has to be implemented. There is a choice of condition, and this is a very beautiful condition or choice that makes transactions easier. I buy your car. How much? 20,000? Here is 20,000. On the condition that I try it for a week. If I don't like it, I'll bring it back and I take my money back. accept? And the man says, accept. So this is called the choice of condition. I put a condition. I rent the house from you. This is 1 month in advance, but I will try it for a week. If I don't like it, you give me back the money. He says, yeah, but I will deduct the amount of 1 week. So this is in agreement, no problem. As long as we agree and there is nothing haram in our agreement, the agreement is final and done. Also, there is the choice of being fooled. What is the choice of being fooled? I come to the market and I have no knowledge of the prices. And I ask the brother, how much is this? He says, oh, this is very expensive. This is 100,000. And I'm new, I don't know. And I take it. And I go to the shop next door and I find the same product. How much is this? This is for 5 rupees only. I bought it for 100,000. Said, well, he made a fortune out of you. This is the choice of being fooled and the choice of ambiguity. This is not acceptable. There is the choice of making something different to what it is really is. When you have a car, before you sell it, what do? You wash it, you polish it, you clean it, you put new parts here and there, because from the outside, looks beautiful. So if I am fooled and I buy this car and then find that there is defect, so this is something that allows me to have the choice. The choice of what? The choice of defect. And we will come to that after a while in explaining the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So this is the choice of defect. The choice of beautification or of showing something that is not what reality is also another choice illustrated, as will it come with us inshallah. When you buy a sheep or a goat and the owner of the goat did not milk it for 7 days, when you come and buy the goat, what do you see? Oh, this goat has a lot of milk. This means that I can have like 5 liters a day. Oh, this is a very healthy and good goat. I will buy it. And after buying it, and I'm milking it for one time, the milk is gone. And it's not generating any new milk. Why? Because he fooled me. They used to do it in Arabia. They tie the breast so it would become big with milk. So the Prophet said, this is up to you, the buyer. If you bought it, now what do you think? You want to go on or cancel it? It's up to you. If you want to cancel it, go ahead. But you have to return it with a sa' of dates, as we will come, inshallah, to discuss. We have a short break. Stay tuned, and inshallah, we'll be right back.
Human being can agree to disagree or disagree to agree. Dispute superstitions and refute the myth which is created around the word religion, which is misinterpreted, misconstrued, and misjudged. Let's wake up from delusion. And step into the world of reality with confidence. Find all the answers to confront or defy, reject or accept, dispute or challenge. When caught in crossfire.
Misconceptions clarified, falsehood exposed, and truth revealed. Discover the reality with Dr. Zakir Naik in Crossfire. Every Saturday at 8:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 12:30 p.m. UK on Peace TV. Peace TV presents over 100 million viewers at one of the largest peace conferences in the world, addressing a sea of spellbound spectators, over 30 world-renowned orators on Islam, with credentials impeccable.
The truth of Islam.
Deen is your way of life.
It is our duty, our obligation.
By following the Quran and Sunnah,
we will give the message to one and all.
With articulation exquisite.
Read the book of Allah.
Islam is the easy way. It's the simple way.
Remind each other.
The Muslim is not a source of harm for other people.
Collaborate with the people for good.
This is the call of Islam.
With the mission of spreading the truth of Islam.
Do what you can to spread the word of Islam.
Wherever we are,
live like Muslims.
Use your power.
Allah is saying, why do you need anything else? This Quran is self-sufficient.
The only book on the face of the globe, the Quran.
How a human being should lead his life is given in this instruction manual, the glorious Quran.
For peace to prevail on earth in peacemakers. Next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome back. So the udder of the goat or of the sheep, once it is tied, it looks bigger than what it really is. So after milking it, you discover that you have been fooled. You have the choice. And there are different types of choices. So it's not only the choice of the location or the gathering area when I buy and sell before separating. No, there are other types. And we have also other explanations to do. Maybe we will take it quickly and then go for the questions. The Prophet ﷺ in the hadith of Hakim ibn Hizam told us about the reasons that we can get blessing of transactions. What are they? Being honest and showing the defects. And no Muslim would hide things from his brother Muslim. Otherwise, his Islam is not complete. Ya Sheikh, I'd like to sell my car, but nobody is going to buy it if I say that it had 6 accidents and 5 rollovers and 10 times the engine broke. Okay, no problem. Nobody buys it, alhamdulillah. But to sell it to someone and not say anything, what will happen? The Prophet tells us, alayhi salam, that if you sell a product and you are honest and you tell the truth and you expose what's wrong in it, Allah will bless the transaction. Even if you get very little money, the money will be blessed by Allah. And the car or the merchandise will be blessed by Allah. Blessing comes from Allah. We need the blessing of Allah in everything we have, in our money, in our health, in our food, in our houses. So if you seek blessings other than Allah, you're doomed. And if you conceal the defects, if you don't tell him, listen, the tire is not good, it's flat, the engine has oil in it, or this or that. If you conceal and you lie, Allah would take the blessing of your transaction. So even if you sell it for a million, so I have a million, I'm a millionaire. What happens next? Your child is ill. Take him to the hospital, they take 200,000 for operation. You make an accident with your car, it's not insured, you give another 300,000. You get illness, you get debts, you get things to pay, the money is gone. There is no barakah. But that first person with 1,000, Allah has blessed it so much, it lasted for a year. And it's generating a lot of barakah to the house. So this we have to always keep in mind. Do we have any questions? Let's start from the right. Yes, the brother at the end.
My question is based on the fourth point which you said. One should possess that object which he is selling. So if I find any natural resource, for example, gold, silver, or any antique, for example, a coin or anything, old coin, so does it make it permissible for me to sell that, or it's a government property or something?
It's called as a rikaz. And this is the treasure found by someone in the ground. So what's the ruling on that? Zakat is due on a number of things. And among them is the things that you find buried in the ground, whether in your property or in the desert, providing it is something that has the seal of disbelievers, meaning it's a treasure of pre-Islamic origin. In this case, yes. And you can utilize it. You have to pay 1/5 of it, if I recall correctly, to the treasury of the Muslims, Bayt al-Mal. If you find gold or silver or minerals in your property, then again, this depends on the Muslim ruler who rules your country. And of course, by default, it depends on the government's regulations. Some countries say that the property and what's in it is yours. In this case, if you find a gold mine, alhamdulillah, it's mine. Some countries say, no, this is for the whole population. We'll give you a compensation and we will confiscate it from you. So I hope this answers the question. From the left, yes, the brother.
Sheikh, as you said, a man purchases a thing for $100. And when he goes to the next shop, he realizes that the thing is of only 5 rupees. Now, can he have the option of getting back to the first store and getting his money back? The second question is that the choice of separation. In this case is where we live in, once the bill gets printed and we are not separated yet, we cannot cancel the deal. Is it valid here, the hadith? Can we cancel the deal?
First, about your question, which deals about buying something far, far, far more than it's actually worth. In Islamic conditions and societies, yes, you have to return it. And some jurors maybe make it into 20%. So if it's less than 20%, it's okay. If you buy something that is 20% or less, more than what the market value is, they say it's okay. This is what some jurors say. But if it's more, like $100 and 5 rupees, there is a sky and earth difference between both of them. Islamically, yes, you can go to the first shop and tell him that you have fooled me in selling it. But are we applying this nowadays? Most shops you will find in the Muslim world, I'm not talking about non-Muslim world. In Muslim world, you'll find a sign saying that whatever you purchase, you cannot return and you cannot refund. Well, who says this? If I buy something and it's broke, what do you mean I cannot return it? I've been cheated. I have the right Islamically, but nobody unfortunately applies the Islamic concept. As for the second question, which is returning the merchandise after the bill was printed. Again, we're talking about Islamic regulations. Even if the bill was printed Islamically, you can cancel the bill and you always have this documentation cancelled and you print a 000 invoice showing that this is was refunded or cancelled Islamically. Yes, you have to. The separation, as in the hadith, is physical. You have to leave. One would say, okay, what about buying on the internet? I put a code or something. This is, again, if they were Islamically dealing with you, yes, turning off your PC would be considered to be separating. Likewise on the phone. If you buy something that you're sure of its description, not someone telling you, I have a car, and you say, I buy it. And you don't see it, you don't know it, you don't know what the specifications. No, if you have a car or some kind of merchandise that you can specifically describe, and it's exactly accurately as you want. And on the phone, I'll buy it, and he says, okay, I'll sell it. Transaction is done. Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam. You hung up. This is considered to be part of the separation. Amir Rahman.
Salaam, Sheikh. When we talk about hiyar, and two people agreeing to certain terms, as we said. But what's the surety?
Okay. Now, in Islam, the sales, the transactions are done verbally. Marriage in Islam is very beautiful, very easy. Try it. The guardian of the girl says to the boy coming, he says, I give you my daughter in marriage. And there are two witnesses or more. And the boy says, I accept. Khalas, it's done. She's married to him. She's married? Yes. No walima, no wedding, no, we didn't discuss the mahar, no need. She's your wife, take her. Likewise in transactions, it is done and confirmed by saying verbally. The man says, I sell you my product for 1,000. And he says, I accept, it's done. After a day or two, you cannot come and say, listen, no one was there, so you have to bring evidence. This happened with the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet outside of Medina saw a man, a Bedouin, with a horse. How much? So and so. I buy it. The man says, I sell it. Khalas, the transaction is done. The Prophet told him, come to Medina, I'll give you the money. The man came to Medina. On the way, he saw a group of tribesmen who saw the horse and gave him more money, not knowing that he already had sold it to the Prophet. So he gave them the horse and took the money and went to Medina. And the Prophet saw him and said, where's my horse? The Bedouin said, what horse? He said, the horse I bought from you. He said, no, I did not sell it. He said, yes, you did. He said, no, I didn't. What can we do? The sale has been done. The Prophet said, السلام, I bought it from you. And the man said, where is your witness? Astaghfirullah. He's saying to the Prophet, السلام, where is your witness? And the Prophet said, I don't have a witness. Khuzaymah ibn Thabit, may Allah be pleased with him, stood up and said, I testify, Prophet of Allah, that you bought the horse from him. He said, Khuzaymah, how do you testify on something you do not see? He said, Prophet of Allah, I believe that the revelation comes to you from the heavens. Don't you want me to believe you in a horse? So the Prophet laughed, alayhi salatu wasalam, and made his testimony, Khuzaymah, may Allah be pleased with him, of two. Usually you need two men to testify on something. The Prophet made his testimony as of two because of that incident. So transactions happen by selling. Someone proposes, I give you my merchandise for this much, and you say, I accept, khalas, it's done. Nowadays, unfortunately, because people are more of cheating and lying, they have to authenticate this. But Islamically speaking, if you go back on your transaction after we have done it, you are sinful at the sight of Allah. Maybe you will escape the punishment here in court or in jail, but you are held accountable at the sight of Allah. Until then, fi amanillah, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK, B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.